Well, that was rather painless. Nice quick service, that's what I like. Although it helps to reserve the item. So the other day I was looking around online and I see this gorgeous ZX6R. It was a 2007 or 8 model and it was absolutely lovely and I was so tempted to get it. So tempted. But I have a bit of an issue though, because I can't test ride any of these bikes because I'm on a restricted license, and that's what you get for passing your test on a 125. So, you know, the 250 is fine for me. I mean, I could ride these bikes if I restrict them, but perhaps only someone out there can confirm what I was told, because I was told that even if you restrict, you know, a big 600 or whatever it is, and yeah, if you restrict them, I was told that you'd still have the same amount of torque that you would normally have if it wasn't restricted. Whether that's true or not, I don't know. So basically that means that I would still be able to get from 0 to 60 in, you know, 3 seconds or whatever it is, or whatever the crazy speed of this thing is. But then it just tops out at 120 instead of, you know, 160. So, whether that's the case, I don't know, because I always thought that it would limit its power to, was it 33 brake horsepower, whatever you limit it to in the UK. But if that's the case, then that means this bike really isn't putting out 33 brake horsepower at all. Which is, I find that very weird. What are these guys doing? I'm not going to try and come up against a massive truck. So yeah, I thought that was rather weird. Because if that's the case, then why would you, you might as well just leave the restriction on there, you know, because if you've got all of the torque that you normally have, and the only limiting factor is the top speed, and you know, I can't do 160 miles an hour, I can only do 120, ooh, you know, big deal. I wouldn't even come close to that on this. In fact, I rarely do 90 on this. So, you know, I just stick to the speed limit. So what is the point of taking the restriction off, if that's the case? But then, what I was told could be completely wrong, and I'll soon find out. Time will tell. It's quite nice weather out here today. Oh, I got some new boots the other day. I'm very impressed with it. They're the Alpine Stars Super Tech R. And the first boot I've ever seen where you've got two boots, you literally have to put on two sets of boots. You put on this little inner boot, which is like an ankle brace, and then you, once you've got that on, you put on an outer boot, which is all the, you know, the outer protective layer, and then when both boots are on, they are actually very comfortable. But your foot literally can't move where it's not supposed to, which is good for protection and all that. Well, it'll be very interesting to see how these videos come out, because I want to know if the I want to know what the background sound is like. I want to know what the voice pickup is like. So I'm hoping it's not going to be as crazy loud as it was before. Although it is a bit windy out here, so I wonder if it's going to pick some of that up. Alright. Well, I'm going to I'm probably gonna call it quits about there. And see you later.